हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू स्टैंडर्ड 10 सब्जेक्ट मैथमेटिक्स चैप्टर 11 कंस्ट्रक्शन। दिस इज लेक्चर नंबर 5। वी आर डूइंग एक्सरसाइज 11.1। नाउ विल सी क्वेश्चन नंबर 5। इन दैट ड्रॉ अ ट्राइंगल विद द साइड बी सी इक्वल टू 6 सेंटीमीटर, ए बी इक्वल टू 5 सेंटीमीटर एंड एंगल ए बी सी इक्वल टू 60 डिग्री। देन कंस्ट्रक्ट अ ट्राइंगल हुज साइड्स आर 3/4 ऑफ द करस्पॉन्डिंग साइड्स ऑफ द ट्राइंगल ए बी सी। So in solution data is, this time the name of triangle is given ABC with BC equal to 6 cm, AB equal to 5 cm and angle ABC is 60 degree given. To construct we need a new triangle. Let the name of new triangle is PBQ of the scale factor 3/4. Again the scale factor, that means the new triangle is 3/4 of the given, 3/4 of the sides of the given triangle. Means 4 is the ratio of given triangle ABC and 3 will be the ratio of the new triangle PBQ. To construct it very simple, this is, we take the base as BC and BC equals to 6 cm given. So we will draw BC of 6 cm here. Let the name of this is BC. It is of 6 cm as given. Now AB is 5 cm, so B to A will be 5 cm, but one more condition, that angle ABC is 60 degree. So BC we have, A is somewhere here which is making 60 degree with angle B. So our aim is we have to take the point A on 60 degree angle. So we will draw 60 degree angle on BC on the point B. How to draw 60 degree? It's so simple. You know, in earlier classes you have understood that how to draw different types of angles on the given line segment. So this is BC line segment given. I want to draw 60 degree on this, on B point. B angle is 60. So on B point we will put the rounder, or taking the center as B, take some arbitrary radius. This much of radius I have taken. Now simply this way we will draw an arc which is intersecting BC and towards upside. Towards downside also we can draw, but it will be better to have on the upper side. And don't change the length which was taken as a radius by the same length, but your rounder point now should be on the intersection point of this drawn arc to BC. So this arc and BC intersecting each other at here. So here we will put our rounder. It's called that we have taken center as that point, and the same radius that was taken previously, we will intersect the previously drawn arc. Now from B point to this intersection point, if we draw a ray, you know that in earlier classes we have seen this will be forming 60 degree angle with the B. This is the rule of construction. By that we know this way we drawn arc from here and intersecting that, and if you draw the ray, this ray will make 60 degree with the given line segment. So 60 degree angle we got on this 60 degree B. A point is needed. At how much distance from B to A distance is 5 cm. So we will take 5 cm radius. 5 and 0 means 5 cm radius is taken. Now put your rounder on B, means center as B, and intersect the drawn arc, drawn radius. Where it intersect at 5 cm, give their A name. Name is A. So this A point we got, which is of 5 cm away from B and making 60 degree angle ABC also. So just join A to C, it is our given triangle actually. This is our given triangle drawn of ratio 4, it is given. Now we need a new triangle PBQ which will be in ratio 3. So 4 is given more and 3 is we have to draw is less. So you can understand that the new triangle will be inside the given triangle. So no need of extending both the sides. We will start simple way, that from B we will draw a ray which is making acute angle with CB, that is CBX, I have drawn again, I will say, such that CBX is less than 90, means acute angle we have drawn. Now on BX, how many arcs we have to draw? Which is more in 3 and 4? 3 and 4, the more value is 4. So 4 arcs we have to draw on the BX. Starting from B, take some arbitrary radius. So 1, 2, 3 and 4. If it is intersecting, so make it clear, visible to the examiner. So it should be clean and clear. So I am extending this and saying that VX on the fourth arc, I will show it clearly with the same length of arc, constant radius we have to take this way. And now give the arc's name as first as B1, second as B2, third as B3 and fourth as B4. As fourth denominator, 4 is on below denominator, this is the ratio of given triangle and given triangle's point is C. B4 to C we have to join. Given triangle's ratio and given triangle's point we will join, B4C. And the new triangle's ratio is 3, so we will draw the parallel to from B3. So how to draw parallel B4C to B3? We have to draw a parallel through B3 to B4C. So we will put your rounder on B4 point exactly and take some arbitrary radius with the some length, constant length we will now take some radius and center as B4, draw this way an arc which is intersecting BB4 and CB4, and the similar arc we have to draw taking the rounder on B3. Put your rounder on B3 by the same arc, similar way we draw the arc, and then we will take the length between these two points of arc which is intersecting on BB4 and CB4. This point and this point, distance we will take, radius as, this point is on rounders, this point is here. Pencils, this point should be up to here, we have to stretch and check it, making the sign this way. This much arc is taken, length between these two, and the similar by the length, we will put your rounder here and cross this arc, new arc. Now, this cross point we have to join through the point B3. B3 to this cross point we have to join. This B3, this line which is parallel to B4C through B3 is drawn, intersecting BC at some point, we will say that point as P. Next, as usual, we will draw PQ here which is parallel to CA. Next step. So a similar way we will go, we will take our rounder on C point now, we will take some radius, suppose this much of radius I have taken, and draw this way an arc which is intersecting the new arc is BC on CA. Similar arc we have to draw from P point also, take your rounder on P point now, make sure that this point is not on this arc, it is on P point is this point, B3P last point, end point. By the same radius, we will draw the same type of arc. Now take the length between these first arc, which is the intersecting point of BC and CA, means here to here. So rounder point on this side point of arc, and pencil point stretch up to this intersection part, and cross this way to sure that this much of length we have taken. And by the same radius, put your rounder on this arc now, which is intersecting on BC, this point, and by the same length which we have measured there, cross this drawn arc. Now this intersection, new intersection point is this, and P point is here. Join a line passing through intersection point and P point, and where it is intersecting ray BA, there it should be stopped, and there you give the name as Q, where it is intersecting PA. So the new triangle, as again we got PBQ is the required triangle of 3:3, and given triangle ABC is of 4:3. You can see it is bigger given, and the newer one is the smaller, some smaller, that is on 3:3. So again the steps we will write here. So steps are, very first step what we have done, we have constructed the triangle ABC with the given measures. So that we will write, construct triangle ABC of given measures also we can write, or you can mention these measures also of given measures, or you can specify that what is given, BC equal to 6 cm, AB equal to 5 cm, ABC equal to 60. That way also you can write. Next step what we have done, we have drawn array BX, means construct array BX such that angle CBX is less than 90. Now how many arcs we have taken on that arc, that ray? 4 arcs. Why? Because the 4 is the greater number from the given ratio. Which is the greater number, that many arcs we draw. So construct 4 arcs on ray BX with constant radius, means by the same radius we have to draw these all arcs, and that radius will be arbitrary. First when you are deciding what, how much should be the radius, that will be the deciding factor. You can take any length, but once you have selected, that will be now constant for each of arc drawing. And that say these arcs as B1, B2, B3 and B4, which is taken on BX. Now the given triangle's ratio is 4 and the given triangle is ABC. So as given triangle's ratio is 4, so from B4 to given triangle's point C, we join a line segment B4C. Join B4C line segment. Then what we have done? We have constructed B3P, which is parallel to B4C, and PQ, which is parallel to CA. So construct B3P and PQ such that B3P is parallel to B4C and PQ is parallel to CA, right? Thus you can see the triangle PBQ. Triangle PBQ is required triangle of ratio 3. Now this way, this construction also we have done. It's so easy, you can see. Thank you.